Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today we are going to look at page numbers in Microsoft Word. We're going to start with the absolute basics of how you even just get a page number onto every single page in Word. Then we'll look at some more advanced topics like how you start your page numbers from a specific page. To follow along, I've included a sample document down below in the description. Let's check this out. Here I am in Microsoft Word, and I want to add page numbers to this document. To insert page numbers, up on the top tabs, let's click on the Insert option. Over on the right-hand side, let's click on Page Number, and here we see several different options. We can insert a page number at the top of the page, and here we can left align it, center align it, or right align it. And if I scroll down, we see a number of different options. You could even add page 1 of 1 or 1 of however many pages you have. And here you have some different formats. I could add a page number to the bottom of my page. And here too, we have some similar formats to what we saw with top of the page. I could also add a page number to the margins, or I could place a page number in the current position. So the current position where my cursor is within the document. I want to place a page number in the bottom right-hand corner. I'll click on bottom of page, and let's go with a right-aligned page number. And here now, you see that Word has added a page number in the footer over on the right-hand side. And here, if I jump through a few of my different pages, there you see the page number everywhere. Now that I've inserted some page numbers, I want to format what these page numbers look like. With the footer selected, I have a new tab up on top called Header and Footer. And over on the far left-hand side, here once again, we see that same page number dropdown. When I click on this, here we have the option to format the page numbers. Now, alternatively, you could also double-click on the page number and then right-click, and here you have that same format option. When I click on this, here I can choose what number format I want. I could even go with letters, or here down below, I see Roman numerals. I'll leave these set as is and then click on OK. These page numbers are starting to look pretty good, but one thing I noticed is there's a page number on the first page, and typically you don't include a page number on the title page. With the footer selected, right up here, there's the option to have a different first page. When I check this box, the page number disappears from the first page, and now I just have the page number starting on the second page, and then it continues on. But if we look here, the number starts at 2, and I want the table of contents to be page number 1. So once again, let's go up to Header and Footer on the top tabs, and then let's click on the Page Number dropdown, and then select Format Page Numbers. And here I can define what the numbering starts at. So currently the title page is page 1, but I want this to be page 0. Here I can lower this to 0. Then I'll click on OK, and now the table of contents starts at 1. That's looking a lot better. When I print out this book, I want the even pages to have the page number on the left-hand side and the odd pages to have the page number on the right-hand side. With the footer still selected, right here I can have different odd and even pages. And when I check that, here now I see that this is an odd page, and here I see that this right here is an even page. So I can modify what these footers look like. Here, the odd page already has it on the right-hand side, so that looks good. But here when I flip the page, the even page is currently also on the right-hand side. I can click into this footer. I'll go up to page number, bottom of page, and here I can left align the page number. And now when I flip through it, that looks just like how it should. Here the even page is on the left side, the odd page is on the right-hand side, and I can see a few more examples here. That's looking really good. Now, I know we've done a lot of work to add these page numbers, but let's also look at how you could remove them. Maybe actually I don't think I need them. Right up above, I'll uncheck different odd and even pages. I'll also uncheck different first page. Over on the left-hand side, once again, under the page number dropdown, here I have the option to remove page numbers. And when I select that, all of the page numbers disappear. Now, alternatively, let's press Ctrl Z to undo. That brings all the page numbers back. I could also click down into the footer, highlight the page number, and then I could simply press backspace or delete, and that's another way to remove the page numbers. Now, of course I want page numbers in my document, but I need to be a little bit more specific about how I want them to appear. I actually want one set of page numbers for my table of contents, and then a different set of page numbers for the text of my book. So how do we do that? We're going to break up this document into separate sections. And to help us with this, let's start by clicking on the Home tab up on top, and let's show the paragraph markings. Here I see all of the paragraph markings, and right here I see that there's a page break between the title page and the table of contents, and then there's another page break between the table of contents and the content of my book. I want to insert section breaks here instead. To delete this, I could simply click in, and here I'll just delete the page break. And here too, I can also delete this page break. Now I want to insert a section break instead. To do that, let's click on the tab titled Layout, and here's a dropdown titled Breaks. Let's click on this, and here I can insert a section break. This behaves like a page break, but it also introduces a new section. Down below, I also want to insert a section break here. I'll click my mouse cursor here, go back up to Breaks, and here I'll select Next Page. And now I've broken this document up into three separate sections. If I click into the header, here I see that this first page is section 1, the table of contents is section 2, and then the contents of my book make up section 3. If for whatever reason I no longer want a section break, or maybe I want to move it to a different location, I can click into my document, and here right before the section break, I can press the delete key, and that removes the section break. Now, of course, I want to keep that, so I'll press Ctrl Z, and that'll bring it back. On the Home tab over here, let's turn off the paragraph marks by clicking this button again. Now that I have three separate sections in my document, I can customize what the page numbers look like for each individual section. Here I'll click into the footer area again. But there's one thing I need to change before I can do that. Right here we see text that says same as previous. So currently whatever I do in this footer right here will carry through to the following footer. Right up here in header and footer, I can click on link to previous. This will break the link between these two footers. So now whatever I do in this footer won't be impacted by this footer up here. I'll go to my third section as well, and let me remove the link between this footer and this footer. Now that I've removed the links, I can now customize what the page numbers look like for each individual section. I'll click into section 2. Then under the header and footer tab, I'll go over to page number, and here I can insert a page number, let's say in the center at the bottom of the page. I'll right click on the page number and then select format page numbers. Here I can format my page number to be, let's say, Roman numerals for the table of contents. Then I'll click on OK. And then here I want a separate page number for this section. I can go up to page number. Let's add it to the bottom of the page, and I'll select the bottom right. Here I'll right click on this number and let's format the page numbers. Here I want it to start at 1 and I'll use the European number format, and then I'll click on OK. So here I have different page number formats depending on the section of my document. This is great, but let's say I want to give my reader some sense of where they are in the document. So maybe I want to say something like page 5 of 23. I can click into the footer, and here I could type text, let's say page, and it currently says 1, and I could enter in of, and I could hard code this. I could go all the way to the end, and it looks like I have 23 pages. I could type in 23. But the only downside is, let's say I insert an additional page. Now the number is no longer accurate. I'll undo that. Instead, I want this number to be dynamic so it represents how many pages I have in my document. I'll remove the hard-coded 23. Let's click back into header and footer, and then let's select the document info dropdown. Let's go down to field, and then within categories, let's select numbering, and here's the option for section pages. I'll click on OK. That returns the number of pages within a section. So here now it says page 23 of 23. If I now insert another page, here you'll notice that it dynamically updates. I'll click on undo. This solution works great if all of the contents are just in one section, but if you end up having multiple sections, this won't work. This number only returns you the number of pages within a section. I'll delete that number. And an even better approach is we can use bookmarks. I'll place my cursor right at the end of end. Let's click on the Insert tab, go over to the Links category, and here let's select Bookmark. I'll type in the bookmark name End, and then click on Add. That's now added a new bookmark. Let's go down to the footer once again, and let's type in Of, and here we are going to insert a cross-reference. Let's click on the Insert tab, click on Links, and here we have the option for cross-reference. I'll select the End bookmark, and over here I can select the reference, and I want to reference the page number that this bookmark is on. Then I'll click on Insert and then Close. This number back here will always reflect the page number that End is on. So let's say I insert another page right here. I'll click on Insert, Page, and let's insert a page break. So here, once again, that continues to work, and this will work even if you have multiple sections. All right, well, that's probably everything you've ever wanted to know about page numbers in Word. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing. I'll see you in the next video.